Hi everyone, Laura here. So today I wanted to talk to you about something that we are all facing at this moment, and that is how to deal with chaos. One thing that I've learned is that we need to become really good at handling chaos, complexity and confusion, because it is everywhere. It always has been and always will be. You as an individual need to become really good at simplifying the chaos that goes on. The chaos that goes on in the world that obviously comes into your mind and that you think about. You need to understand what is a signal and what is noise. So a signal is something that needs your attention, that's something that you should be focusing on. And noise is obviously just the clutter that sort of takes up most of the space in your head. Being able to develop mental categories when faced with confusion, chaos, and complexity is the first step to actually dealing with it. Once you understand what these categories are, you will then be able to implement them in your everyday life and therefore be able to clear out the clutter, clear out that confusion, and sort of make better, more concise decisions and really focus on what exactly needs your attention. I have developed what I like to call a look-through lens that you could potentially use in your life in order to help declutter that chaos that goes on in your head. So for me, the first step is accept. Accept that there is constantly going to be chaos, confusion, complexity in the world, whether we like it or not. And no matter how simple your life might be, there is always going to be chaos and confusion that's going on in the world around us. Once you accept this, your world will truly change. If this is the only thing that you do out of all these steps, trust me, it will be one of the best ones you can do. The second sort of mental category that you can go through is time. I understand that a lot of you do not have time to set aside time. So therefore, if you're faced with something that you feel really pressured about, or you feel really uncertain and it just feels chaotic when you think about it going on in your head, do not answer to it. Do not deal with it. Just put it to the side for now. If you respond while you're feeling overwhelmed, while you're feeling uncertain, while you're feeling anxious, the outcome of that will not be what you wanted. The third step is feel. And those who know me know that I truly 110% believe in this. You should feel what you're feeling. I experienced this feeling of anxiety and confusion and complexity a couple of months ago when I lost my job. I sort of came home and I thought, now what? And while I was sitting in bed, I sort of had this realization that it's not about the bigger picture. It's just about that next step forward. So don't focus on the things that seem really daunting and really scary now, but focus on that next step forward. Step four is say no. This is a lesson that I sort of need to tell myself, because I am guilty of it. There is so much going on in the world and so much opportunity and just so many things that we can do. And although it's great to say yes to adventures and yes to new opportunity, there are certain things that do not serve a purpose to you, and you as an individual need to understand what those things are and say no. So maintain a say yes to life attitude while consciously choosing where you spend your time and energy. Number five, and possibly the most important and most difficult to do, that is reframe. Reframe your thoughts about experiences, about failures. Reframe them into a new light in the way that you see them. Remember, failure at the end of the day does not mean you have failed. That's the end of the line. Failure is merely a lesson learned on how to do things better the next time. As a young entrepreneur, you will know, I know, that failure is incredibly important in growing who we are as individuals and as individual brands and how we present ourselves in the market. But remember, the way you see the problem might just be the problem. Reframe your thoughts in order to see life in a new light. In recap, it's accept, time, feel, say no, reframe. Those five simple steps will help you simplify your life. Let me know your thoughts, let me know your feedback. I'd love to hear from you guys. Until next time, I hope you guys are all staying safe out there. Bye for now. We are the monsters causing trouble.